Good. If you have your Bibles, like, will you turn with me to James, the first chapter? James, the first chapter, 17th verse. The Bible says, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above.
Amen.
It cometh down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. I want to focus intently on the first part of this verse. How many got a good Christmas present this year? Anybody? Okay, praise the Lord. Amen, that's good. That make you smile? Now how long will that last, that smile? Huh? They say diamonds are forever. Did anybody get a diamond for Christmas? One. Two. Liars. Liars all night. Nobody got a diamond.
Betty did.
Praise
Betty
did. Oh, one did. Okay, Betty did, and she's watching the children.
Probably
why
she got a diamond.
Praise the Lord. Sister Mandy, you ever lost a diamond?
Oh.
Man. Now, do you want to get a church on their knees? No, I'm serious. Business. Amen. You want to get a church on their knees, you tell them that somebody lost a diamond in the altar. Amen. I had never seen so many people crawling around a church on their knees. It was better than any prayer meeting I'd ever seen. Sure enough, she found it. Wasn't in the floor. I think... in her pocket or something when she took her clothes, and then it fell right out. There it was. Praise the Lord. After all that crawling around. Praise the Lord. I wish we would realize that there's something to be had in a relationship with the Lord that lasts forever other than just shiny things. Amen?
Right.
Amen. Praise the Lord. There is. This scripture says that every good gift is from the Father of lights, and that's kind of what I want to take a little liberty with and use a little phrase from a Gretchen Wilson song, not that I listen to her anymore. But it's talking about, I think it was a redneck woman, and it says, I leave my Christmas lights on all year long. Now, if there are any of you here that actually leave your Christmas lights up all year long, don't tell anybody. But what I want you to do is I want you to leave your Christmas lights on all year long.
Amen.
And what I mean by that, spiritually speaking, we come into this season with great anticipation and expectation of the gifts that we'll receive or the joy that we will receive from giving gifts. And it's exciting. Even when you're not a kid anymore, I'm just a big kid.
Come on.
Amen.
Right.
But I got a bad habit of buying myself Christmas presents. Does anybody else do that? Sister Jelly and I got to an age where we'll show one another what we got and say, hey, look what you got me for Christmas. Oh, honey, I hope you enjoy. Amen. It works much better than getting something that you don't like.
Right.
Amen. Amen, right?
That's right.
Amen. But Christmas time comes with such great anticipation and excitement. And everywhere you look, there are these people putting out lights. You drive into my neighborhood, and the word Jesus in a front yard is probably 30 foot long and 6 foot tall, all lit up. And I'm like, those people really know what Christmas is all about. And that's beautiful. And that's what it's all about. That's what every single light that is lit, that's what it's about.
Right.
The birth of Christ.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Every single tree that's put up, it's not about Santa Claus.
That's right.
It's about Christ.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Even though it's pagan worship from the Old Testament, we won't talk about that. Amen. But, you know, we were picking Kayla up from her house today to bring her to church. Good job, Angie. she picked somebody up. So did you pick somebody up? No, Bucky, who did you pick somebody up?
No.
Who picked Todd up?
I walked.
Oh, that's even better. I was picking Kayla up from from her house, and off to one side, people were beginning to take the lights down. And drove a little bit further, there were deflated Santas laying in the yard. Oh. It won't be long till that big Jesus isn't in that yard anymore. Christmas comes and goes. One thing remains the same. Jesus was given as a gift for you to enjoy all year long.
Amen. That's right.
And so, you know, we wouldn't have any problem designating Jesus as the light of the world. As a matter of fact, he said it, I am.
That's right.
The light of the world. So if you believe the Bible, if you believe in God, you believe that Jesus is the light of the world.
Right, man.
But Jesus goes a little further in the way that he describes things, and I'd like to take you to John, the 12th chapter, if you would go along with me this morning. John, the 12th chapter, and read one or so verses of Scripture, and allow the Lord just to minister to you through this text. Jesus was speaking of himself, and he said, while you have light, believe in the light. That ye may be the children of light.
Right.
The Lord gave us a glorious opportunity. His coming was for a divine purpose, and that was so that we could be transformed from the children of disobedience into the children of obedience. The Scripture delineates it as far as, while once we were children of darkness, now through Jesus Christ, we can become the children of light. Amen?
Right.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I've often wanted to do a service in July and call it Christmas in July and do the manger scene and the play and the decorations and everything so that the world would think that we've gone crazy.
Right.
You know?
Amen.
Because the world has gone crazy.
Right. That's right.
And as the children of light, we hold the truth in these earthen vessels to the point where that we need the world to see the light.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen. That's why they sang that old song, I Saw the Light. Ephesians, the 5th chapter, if you would follow along with me, I want to take you through somewhat of a transformation. Because all of us, the Bible says, like sheep, have gone astray.
Right.
Amen. And at some point, one scripture said, once while you were in darkness, now you are in the light.
Right.
That's the way that we should be. Unfortunately, it's not that way, and that's why I'm preaching. Let's keep the excitement of Christmas going all year long.
Right.
Let's keep the celebration going all year long, that people will know that our joy doesn't come from getting a diamond.
Right. Amen. Right.
But our joy comes from the Lord. Every good gift comes from the Father
Amen.
Of lights.
That's right.
He's the one who said, let there be light.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
So if we're going to shine, let us shine to glorify Him who is in heaven. Amen.
Right.
In the name of Jesus.
Right.
Ephesians the 5th chapter, this is just before the armor of God scriptures, but the 5th chapter, around the 8th and 9th verses, the Bible says here, that we were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of light.
Amen.
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 Amen. So if you're a Christian in today's society, someone should know it.
That's right.
Amen. People know it if you decorate for Christmas.
That's right.
Right.
Amen. Amen. People know how much time you spent doing it too.
Right.
Yeah.
I won't say anything about you. I won't say anything about you. I won't say anything about you.
Amen.
For sometimes we were in darkness. I think it was you that was asking what's a good neighborhood to go to show your kids a neighborhood that really goes all out. And I love those neighborhoods that go all out for Christmas, and it's like a traffic jam getting in and out, and you roll the windows down and you look, and it's just awesome to see such brilliance.
Right.
Go through there in a week or two.
Right.
And you're going to see the real them.
Yeah.
Amen. They might not even let you in their neighborhood.
That's right. That's right.
Since Christmas is over.
Mm-hmm.
And I've gone to some wonderful displays of light, and there used to be one in St. Pete that we'd go to every year, and I think over at the Botanical Gardens, they do a wonderful display, and the lights are just brilliant, and every one of those came from the Lord. If it wasn't
right.
for the Lord,
right.
you know, there wouldn't be light. We would all still be in darkness. And so I think that maybe the spiritual implications of what we celebrate and how we celebrate, maybe we should take that to the inside of us, because the Bible says here that the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth. Amen. So if you want to display your Christmas spirit all year long, these are the attributes that you're going to have to tap into that you can shine for Jesus Christ all year long.
Right.
They get so excited, and I don't want to get political this morning about mangers on public property and things along this line. I was happy to see in a few of the cities that I deal with around here that they were celebrating Christmas. What's happening, though, is the minority is beginning to try to rule, and they basically have to be stepped on with the heel of your shoe.
Amen.
Or before you know it,
they're
going to be, the godless minority is going to be in control.
Right.
And then you won't have a voice.
Right.
Right.
Amen. Because let me tell you, the liberty that you now enjoy, and I'm not going to go too far, and no, I don't want people teaching my children Muslim stuff at school. No, I don't want that. But this ain't a Muslim nation.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Merry Christmas.
I'm just going to tell you.
Merry Christmas.
That's right. And what I'm telling you is what we're getting put into is this box. And the people, this is only going to be able to fit so many people in the box, and the box is going to bust, and you're going to have a mess.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's what's happening now. That's what happened with all this whole Chick-fil-A and the Dynasty. And that's what happened is you had a minority of people. And with Hollywood in control, you would think that half the population was homosexual.
Yeah.
Right.
It's not.
Right.
It's barely 4% of the people in America has those leanings. But you would think that it's everywhere. And let me tell you what's going to happen. And what I was getting on is the Christmas spirit. The reason for Christmas, in some of these places, it's being squelched to the point where you can't even say Merry Christmas.
Right.
You go into some of these stores and they'll say Happy Holidays, and then you tell them Merry Christmas and they say, oh, thank God. They want somebody to tell the truth.
Yes.
Right. That's right.
They want somebody to tell them why that we're celebrating
that's
what
right.
we're celebrating.
That's
amen.
Right.
We're not celebrating a tree,
that's right.
a jolly red man in a red suit coming down your chimney, and
that's
you ain't
right.
even got a chimney.
Right.
That's right.
How does that work for you?
Being entering.
I want smarter children than that.
B&E.
Children should be asking questions. But we don't have a chimney. Well, then just let me have the cookies, will you?
Oreo.
Amen. We had one sister. She basically said, I ain't going to let him take the credit for what I've done. I worked hard to provide a good Christmas for my children. Ain't nobody
Amen.
Taking credit for that except the Lord. Thank God.
Amen.
But you walk
Amen.
Into these stores and they can't even tell you Merry Christmas because of this minority people of some other religion or some other persuasion thinking that they're going to dominate this country and these people. It ain't going to happen.
That's right.
I don't care who it is. It ain't going to happen. I preached a message. We lost a few people the other day about not bowing down. If you're the bowing down type, this ain't the church for you.
Right.
That's right.
That's right.
I mean, as a matter of fact, you'll find out pretty quick.
Right.
And you say, well, that's not very compassionate. No, it's extra compassionate. I'll tell you what's not compassionate is letting people live their entire lives without anybody telling them the truth.
Right.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
It's frustrating. It's very frustrating. And you know, you workplaces now will fire you if you put your opinion on your Facebook.
That's right.
Amen. If you put what you really believe on your Facebook, there's some workplaces. But you know what? They have a placard in their hallway that says, oh, we do not discriminate against any religion, whatever. Well, they're discriminating against a Christian because a Christian's supposed to shut up while everybody else does everything. I see it.
Yep.
Come on.
I see it all the time. There's laws against not discriminating against people with religious persuasions, but it counts for everybody except for the people who were right.
Yeah.
Who were right. Amen.
Right.
And you know what? It's going to come to a point where you're either going to roll over or you're going to stand up.
That's right.
So what I want to do is I want to celebrate Christmas all the time. It's fun.
Amen.
People often gig me for singing Christmas songs when it's not Christmas. But I dare you to keep singing.
Amen. Come on.
That's right.
I dare you to keep singing. And then when asked, why are you still singing Christmas songs? It's because Christ is eternal.
That's
and
right.
He's real.
Yes,
he didn't just come to be a baby and get gifts. He came to give gifts.
Amen.
Right. And he has given gifts.
Yes.
He's given gifts to us. He's given the gift of salvation. He's given the gifts of people who are talented to be in leadership. He's given gifts to people who can make us whole. He's given gifts to people who can teach us. And he's given gifts to people who can coordinate things.
Amen.
He's the gift giver, and every good gift comes from above.
Amen.
And that's why I'm still singing Christmas songs in January and in February, because I'm excited about what Jesus came to do.
Amen.
Did you know that?
Happy holidays. Amen. Amen. Think about it. You can make a difference. You can make a difference.
Amen.
You can make a difference. People already ask me why I'm singing just on Monday.
Right.
How can you sing on Monday?
Amen.
Well, I didn't do the same thing you did this weekend. I don't have the guilt. I'm not worn out. I rested. I took a nap.
Amen.
I enjoyed life in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
And so I'm still singing. Amen.
Right.
The world song plays out.
Right.
Between Saturday night and Sunday morning.
Right.
And their melody just ceases somewhere into oblivion.
Mm.
Bible goes on to say in a few of these scriptures, it says, those that are drunken, they're drunken in the night.
Right.
But we live in sobriety.
Amen.
As children of light.
Right.
So God gave us opportunities. The Father of lights, He is the light. And He gave us the opportunity to be children of light.
Amen.
It's all the scriptures that we've shared. And we'll go just a little bit further. 1 Thessalonians, if you would, 5:5. If you would like to follow along with me, it says, ye are all the children of light, and the children of the day. We are not of the night, nor of darkness.
Amen.
It goes on a little bit further. I don't know how much you want to hear.
But
it says, therefore, let us not sleep as do others.
Right.
But let us watch and be sober.
Right.
For they that sleep, sleep in the night. And they that be drunken are drunken in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith. Amen.
Come on.
And of love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. It's a beautiful thing, amen, to see the distinction.
Yeah.
And there is a distinction. We have to be careful. And there's one last scripture that I want to share with you from Luke. And this subject is all about being children of light, where light comes from.
Right.
But you have to be very careful, because the Bible says that Satan himself can transform into what looks like an angel of light. So you have to be very careful in this world because there are things that will masquerade themselves as truth.
Yep.
Like the truth is, there are a couple of holidays around the end of the year. Right?
Right, yeah.
What are they? Thanksgiving. To who?
Come on.
Christmas.
Right.
From who?
Right.
A Happy New Year.
Mm-hmm.
So they take the Happy New Year and they make it a holiday. But they can't say anything about Christmas or Thanksgiving because it has something to do with God. You watch. It won't be long. They'll try to transform Thanksgiving into something else.
That's right.
Amen?
Amen.
A no work day. Happy no work day. Why are we doing this, Daddy? I don't know. My dad just said he didn't have to work on the Thursday of the last of November.
So he can shop.
Why are we doing all this? Why are we putting all these lights up, Daddy? Well, we got to keep up with the neighbors. Got to explain the birth of a Savior.
Amen.
Right.
And the message carries on into salvation. And then salvation carries on into fruit. And then before you know it, we're singing about Christmas.
Amen.
Amen.
July.
All year long.
Amen.
Amen. So the 11th chapter of Luke and the 35th verse, it has a little warning. Because things will masquerade themselves as truth, and before you know it, you'll be saying just like it. And I've caught myself. Has anybody ever caught themselves writing out Christmas and wanting to put Xmas?
Yep.
Just because you're tired of writing?
No.
No?
No.
Liar. I'm just who was answering? I didn't even see who was answering. I put it on a sign one time. Oh, they got mad. I put, "You'll think Xmas."
Amen. Yeah.
Wait just a little while.
Yeah.
You'll see.
That's right.
Amen.
So.
Every once in a while, we need to wake them up.
Right.
Let them realize. But the truth masquerades as holiday time. So happy holidays sounds reasonable, doesn't it?
Right.
That sounds sweet, and you can smile about it. But when the holidays is over, guess what? It's not happy anymore.
Amen.
Right. Come on.
But if you know the real reason of Christmas, and if you know the whole story, then you can be happy all the time, and you don't have to quit. And you know what? We don't have to quit giving gifts.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
We don't have to quit.
Right.
Amen. You can give me something next Sunday. I won't. But, okay, so did everybody get something for Christmas? Did everybody get something for Christmas? All right. Praise the Lord. Did you get Jesus anything? I forgot. I remember when I was a child, there was a cartoon, an editorial in the newspaper, and it had this man standing at a desk, and he had a list that was just rolling over, and there were presents stacked up behind him to the point where that he was surrounded by gifts that were wrapped, and he said, "Now have I forgotten anybody?" And in the gifts was the face of Christ. Sometimes we forget. And none of you raised your hand about did you get Jesus anything, but there were a couple of us that gave of ourselves on Christmas Day.
Right.
That's right.
I got a question for you. How many spent your part of your Christmas holiday feeding the hungry at Clearwater? How many was down there this past Christmas dinner that we fed them? You can raise your hand. It's okay. I won't take your reward away from you. Some of them went out Christmas Day collecting homeless people to take to a restaurant that opens their doors on Christmas Day to feed people that can't afford to eat. And so some of our people ran their trucks and their vans around the neighborhood looking for homeless people. And they fed 100-something homeless people on Christmas Day. They gave something to Jesus that day.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Don't cut yourself short. Because some of you give of yourselves all the time. And the Bible says when you've done it unto the least of these, it's just like as if you've done it unto me. And that's Jesus speaking.
Amen.
And so you did give Jesus something. When you do something for the church, When you do something for the body of Christ, it does something. Some of you teach, and some of you sing, and some of you lend your talents to the Lord, and it's a beautiful thing. You're giving something of yourself. And I don't think there's any greater thing that we could do than give of ourselves.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's right.
I give myself to you.
Amen.
That's right.
So you can use me. I believe that if it were possible, the Lord would have us decorated for Christmas all year long.
That's right.
In here. Where our smile never changed from the same anticipation of Christmas and the same joy of seeing our... I'll tell you, I love those pictures. Catching the excitement of a child opening that gift. There was one, I think it was one of the Hughes... girls. It was a picture from the 60s or the 70s, and her eyes were so wide and her mouth was open, and she was looking at this gift, and it was such a beautiful expression. I would love if we had a relationship with the Lord that overflowed in the areas of our life beyond Monday morning.
Amen.
Somebody come in here and you amen and you nod, but before you ever get out of church, the Grinch that stole Christmas
right
has already started whispering in your ear.
Man, come on.
He said, oh, that was a good word.
Oh, no.
That's right.
When we were bad a long time ago, our parents used to say, you're not getting anything for Christmas.
A lump of coal.
Yeah, it was a lump of coal. For me, it was a bundle of switches.
I'll take the coal.
I'll take the coal, too. I'd be happy to get some coal. Yeah. For those of you who have been raised up without discipline, a switch. Stings. It's not what the Lord wants to do for you. He wants to give you gifts that will benefit you to the point where that you can be happy, and that it shows up in truth, in the way that you treat people, in the way that you act, in the way that you talk. The Lord wants to be glorified all year long.
Amen.
What I wanted just to relate to you in this funny kind of way is I want you to leave your Christmas lights on all year long.
Amen.
All year long. It may cost a little extra sacrifice. But believe me, it'll make a difference.
Amen.
When people ask you, why are you happy? Be ready to tell them. Why are you singing? Be ready to tell them. Why are you unshaken in this shaken world? Because I have a blessed anchor for my soul.
That's
Christ
right.
Jesus.
That's right. Thank you, Lord.
And the reason for Christmas.
Yes.
Amen.
Right. Amen.
Amen. The Bible says here in 11 and 35 that we need to be careful and take heed, therefore, that the light which is in thee be not darkness. Mm. How can that happen? You know, there's a principle that the Lord puts out about taking communion. And he says, don't be taking communion unworthily.
Right.
Some people take communion every week, but they live with all their lights off.
Right.
As if they've never decorated their house.
That's right.
The Lord wants you to be thoroughly furnished with good things, good gifts. Every one of those gifts comes from above, Father lights, in whom there's no variableness of turning. No shadow. It's all light. Because it's in Him. Sometimes we have to examine ourselves and see whether or not the way that we're living, the light that's in us, we have to be careful that it's not of our own making.
That's right.
It's not. So you can truly sing, worship the Lord, live out His teachings before men. That's leaving your light on.
Right.
Amen.
Amen. You never know when somebody might be ready to come home.
Right. Come on.
Amen.
Amen. There's a couple of country songs that talk about how to leave the light on just so you can find your way back home. You may be the light.
Right.
You may be the star in God's purposes that leads someone back to Christ.
Amen.
Or to Christ in the first. Maybe they ask you, why? Why? Why are you happy? Because Jesus came on Christmas Day. Maybe he did. Maybe it was a different day. We don't even know it was December.
Right.
So why not celebrate every day?
Right, that's right.
Like it's Christmas Day.
Come on.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Somebody may be able to find their way back home. Would you stand with me? That is right.